Hello everyone. Today, in this lecture, we will discuss about chapter 5th from Supplementary Reader, that is Footprints Without Feet. The story is about scientist who discovers how to make himself invisible. As he was afraid of being discovered in London, where he had committed some crimes, he runs away to a remote village. However, he runs out of money and resorts to robbery, using his advantage of invisibility. Before we start, let's talk about the characters. So, the main character here is Griffin. He is the scientist who makes himself invisible. He does not hesitate to resort to criminal activities to remain a mystery. Second is Mrs. Hall. She is the resolute but superstitious owner of the inn at Lipping where Griffin stays. Third is Mr. Zuffers. He is a dutiful policeman who fails to arrest the invisible scientist. So, let's start the chapter. So, the story starts with the two boys on the street were surprised to see fresh muddy footprints of bare feet on the steps of a house without finding who was making them. Further on, the footprints disappeared. This footprint had been made by Griffin, an eccentric scientist who had discovered how to make his body transparent. He could only be seen by the cloth he was wearing. Griffin was having a criminal bent of mind and was a lawless person. He set fire to his landlord's house to take revenge against him for trying to evict him. To get away, he had to remove his clothes so that he became invisible. He was a homeless wanderer in London without clothes or money during winter. Next, Griffin managed to escape from the two keen boys' observation and entered unseen into a big store to get warm. After the store was closed at night, Griffin put on some new clothes, consumed meat and coffee from the restaurant in the store, and went to sleep on a pile of quilt. He overslept and only woke up when the shop had opened and the assistant had arrived. On being seen and chased by them, he again took off his clothes so that they could not see him. Now, the Griffin entered a theatrical company giving items used in play. There, he wore bandage to outline his face, dark glasses, a false nose, and bushy side whisker. He robbed the shopkeeper of his money and escaped to a village away from the London to avoid being caught. Now, Griffin arrives at Lipping village. Griffin booked two rooms at an inn belonging to Mrs. Hall in the village Lipping. He explained to her that he had an accident and did not want to be disturbed. As Mrs. Hall tried to be social with him, soon his money was finished and so he robbed a clergyman's house by using his invisibility. Mrs. Hall enters the Griffin's room. That same day, when Mrs. Hall found the Griffin's room open, with his bandage and clothes lying around, she and her husband enter the room. Suddenly, both of them were attacked by the furniture being flung at them, but they could not see who was doing this. Mrs. Hall felt that the furniture was haunted by spirits as she could not see Griffin. Griffins become invisible and escape from Lepping. And it was when the clergyman reported the burglary to the police. Most people in the village felt that the strange scientist had a hand in it, because he paid his due rent, whereas earlier he was not able to do so. So, Mr. Zafar, the village police constable, was called to arrest Griffin. Meanwhile, Mrs. Hall asked Griffin to explain all the unusual happenings. Griffin lost his temper and decided to tell all. He started removing his clothes, and even Zafar could not catch someone whom he could not see. He was knocked out unconscious by the invisible man who escaped. There was nervous, excited cries of "Hold him!" But this was easier said than done. Griffin had shaken himself free, and no one knew where to lay hands on him. So this was the overall chapter. Hope you understood it properly. Thank you.